Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today, I will give a complete introduction to all the features of CutsTools, along with the new features added in version 1.3.0. First, let's review the basic features of CutsTools. Select your model and enter edit mode, then choose the edges you want to cut. Press Shift plus Q to enter cutting mode. When your mouse hovers over the mesh, a live parameter adjustment UI will appear. Left-click to confirm the cut gap. CutsTools is a non-destructive modeling tool, so you can continue editing the original model after cutting. If you want to remove the cut gap, simply select the edges of the cut gap and press Shift plus Q again to restore it. Select your model and enter edit mode, then pick the edges you want to cut. Press Shift plus Q to activate the cutting mode. Hold down Ctrl and move your mouse left or right to adjust the cut thickness. Hold Alt and move the mouse left or right to control the offset of the thickness. Pressing the O key toggles the cap beneath the thickness on or off. Now, let me explain the bevel section. Press Shift plus Q to activate the cutting mode. Hold Shift and slide the mouse left or right to control the bevel width. Hold Ctrl plus Shift to fine-tune the bevel width more precisely. Use the mouse wheel to adjust the number of segments for the bevel cut. Hold the P key and slide the mouse left or right to control the bevel profile shape. Press the A key to switch between four bevel limit modes, and I recommend using the weight mode. Only when the limit mode is set to angle, holding Shift plus A and sliding the mouse left or right will adjust the angle. This angle controls beveling only on edges where the adjacent faces form an angle less than the threshold. The angle parameter can be tricky to control. Press M to toggle between three miter outer modes, which only take effect when the limit mode is angle. Press I to switch between two inner modes. When in arc mode, hold S to control the spread value, which is also influenced by the angle setting. Next, press C to toggle clamp overlap on or off. When clamp overlap is enabled, the bevel width is limited to the smallest distance between bevel edges, and adjustments beyond this won't take effect. Disabling clamp overlap removes this limit. Finally, press N to toggle harden normals. If you notice any odd behavior during cutting, try toggling this option to fix it. After selecting edges and pressing Shift plus Q to enter cutting mode, if the limit mode is set to weight, hold Alt plus Q, then release Alt and move the mouse left or right. You can individually control the width of the cut edges. My recommendation is to set a relatively large maximum cut gap width at the beginning, so that later you can adjust the width of each cut gap segment individually. After finishing the cut, select the cut edges. And similarly, hold Alt plus Q and move the mouse left or right to adjust the cut edge width individually. This feature also has another use. When your model has a bevel modifier applied and the limit mode is set to weight, select the edges you want to bevel. Hold Alt plus Q and move the mouse left or right. You can individually control the bevel width of those edges. Select the corner vertices. Hold Ctrl plus Q and move the mouse left or right to individually control the vertex weights and create sharp corner effect. Next, let me introduce the new features in CutsTools 1.3.0. I added 6 preset bevel profiles to CutsTools. After selecting edges and pressing Shift plus Q to enter cutting mode, you can press the number keys 1 through 6 on your keyboard to switch between the different preset bevel profiles. Holding down the P key and moving the mouse left or right will revert to the original profile control mode for fine adjustments. Next, let me explain the redirect feature. Select a vertex on the cross point of your model. Press Shift plus Ctrl plus C to enter redirect mode. Use the mouse wheel to choose the redirect direction you want, then left-click to confirm. This will change the edge flow around that cross point based on your selection. After entering redirect mode, use the wheel to pick the direction, and press number keys 1 through 9 to control the distance between the two redirected points and the corner point. 1 means the 2 points are closest to the corner. 9 means they are farthest away. If you confirm without pressing a number key, the default distance is 1/3 of the corner distance. Then select the redirected corner point. Press Shift plus Control plus C again, and the redirected edge flow will be restored back to the original cross shape. This feature allows you to quickly change the edge flow direction. When cutting on a curved model using Cuts Tools, holding Ctrl plus Q to set vertex weights for sharpening corners may cause the issue shown in the video. In such cases, you can use the redirect function to quickly turn rounded corners into sharp corners. Additionally, during base modeling or retopology, this feature can be used to quickly adjust edge flow directions and achieve the desired modeling or topology structure. Next, let's talk about the preferences. I've added individual toggles for each main feature, so you can enable or disable the functions you want to use according to your needs. That's all for this update. Thank you so much for watching. The plugin download link is below. If you enjoyed this video and the content, please like, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss future updates. See you next time. Bye.